Edexcel AS Mathematics, Core Mathematics C1, from May 2011. That was a Wednesday, by the way. Question 4. I've been asked to solve the simultaneous equations given. One of these equations is quite simply in terms of x and y. The other in terms of x squared and y squared. Now, to solve simultaneous equations, I need to find either what x equals or y equals and substitute it in to the other equation. Quite clearly, the first equation is easiest to rearrange. I can write it as x equals or y equals. Both methods will work. In fact, it wouldn't make much difference which one I choose. I'm going to choose x equals just because, to me, there is just an x here with no coefficient, whereas the y squared has a coefficient of 4. There's very little difference in this. So the first equation becomes x equals 2 minus y. And if I substitute this in to my second equation, so 4y squared minus, only instead of x, I'm going to write 2 minus y squared is equal to 11. There is a quadratic equation, maybe not as straightforward as you'd like, in terms of y, which I will now be able to solve. Now, it's important to point out at this stage that solve in an exam question means find the variables. My variables here are x and y, which means at the end of this question, I will have x equals and a y equals. Many people forget that. You'll be pleased to know that at this stage, I've got a method mark for finding what x or y equals, and another method mark for substituting it in to the equation. So without any hard algebra at all, I've got 2 of these 7 marks. So even if you struggle sometimes with your algebra, knowing how to solve equations and how to solve questions will get you marks. So let's set about doing this. It's a 7 mark question. There's going to be many steps. Just take your time. Okay? I'm even going to write out what 2 minus y squared is. Many people make the mistake of writing 2 squared minus y squared. Well, that's not what it means, and you should know that. So maybe writing that out every time will remind you. It's not a waste of time if it helps you get the marks. This gives me 4y squared minus, well, many of you do this slightly differently, the FOIL method, the smiley face method. Whatever works for you, as long as it's accurate, make sure you've checked that with your teacher. But you multiply this out, and you should get 4 minus 4y plus y squared is equal to 11. Now, I will need to multiply this bracket out, because there's a minus in front of the whole thing. So this will be minus 4, but it will be plus 4y. So I need to be careful when I'm doing that. So, just showing every step of my calculation, this becomes minus 4 plus 4y minus y squared is equal to 11. And if I group all of the like terms, bring the 11 across, I see that 3y squared plus 4y minus 15 is equal to 0. And that is a straightforward, even if it's not as easy to solve as you'd like, a straightforward quadratic equation. And so getting to this stage and getting it correct, I've got my third mark of this question. It's an accuracy mark, so I need to have got the correct quadratic. I now need to solve this. I can do it in any way I see fit. It's C1, which means they're likely going to factorise. Doesn't mean they are going to factorise. You do need to know the formula, but, you know, as a rule of thumb, most of your C1 questions probably will, because you don't have a calculator paper. I know many of you struggle, or don't like factorising, when there's a 3 in front. I mean, many of you will say, it's alright, I can do this one in my head, because it's going to have to be 3y and y, simply because 3 is a prime number. But really, you should know the method for factorising these equations. You can go straight to this line in the examination. I'd recommend it if you can. If it takes more than a second's thought, it It's not a waste of time to show you working out, so I'll do that on the next slide. Now you need to know this method. 3 times the minus 15 is minus 45. So I'm looking for factors of minus 45 that would give me the 4 in the middle. Start with the obvious ones you know. You might say, well, 3 and 15. But there's no way I can use the numbers 3 and 15 to make the number 4. You should know another one, just thinking very quickly through, is 5 and 9. Now, the difference between 5 and 9 is indeed 4. So to make minus 45, one of these would have to be a negative. 5 take away 9 is minus 4. 9 minus 5 is 4. So I'm going to use these two factors here. They do not go into your brackets. Many people make that mistake. I need to rewrite my quadratic equation. Doesn't matter which way you do it. I always try and pair up nice multiples of each other. But plus 9y minus 5y minus 15. I've not done any factorising at this stage. I've just rewritten 4y as 9y minus 5y. I'm now going to factorise this expression at the front. So I'm going to pull out, 3y, leaving me with y plus 3. And then I'm going to factorise the back two terms there. So I'm going to pull out minus 5, and that leaves me with y plus 3. And that's still all equal to 0. You know you've done it right if these two brackets are the same. So that's one of your brackets. If they're not the same, it doesn't mean you've done it wrong. It means you may not have factorised it completely properly. So check your answer. Your other bracket is made up of these two terms, 3y minus 5. And that's all equal to 0. As I say, if you see that factorisation, you can go straight to it. You could use the formula, but the best ways are often the simplest, working your way through, knowing you're doing it correct. You'll be pleased to know, at this stage, you get a method mark. Now, if you just factorised it, you'd get that method mark. If you use the formula, you'd get that method mark. You're obviously doing some method that's helping you solve this equation. From here, I'm able to find what y is equal. So I'll do that on the next page. So from my factorisation, I'm able to see that y is equal to minus 3 and y is equal to 5/3. You should be able to go straight to that line. If you're struggling a little bit, what I actually did there was you let each bracket equal 0 in its own right. So you then solve that mini equation that you've just written, and you can see that leads to the line I've got there. The reasoning being that one something times something is 0, either that is 0 or that is 0. So either y is minus 3 or y is 5/3. Unsurprisingly, at this stage, if I get them both correct, I get an accuracy mark. Now, all I need to do is look back in this question, and you'll see that look back at the top here, you'll see that x was equal to 2 minus y. So, putting this in, I was going to say to my calculator, you don't have a calculator, but thinking about this, minus 3, so 2 minus 3 is equal to 2 minus minus 3 becomes 2 plus 3, which is 5. Little bit trickier, 2 minus 5/3. Well, 5/3 is 1 2/3. So 2 minus 1 is 1, and the other 2/3 leaves me with 1/3. And that's x, not y. These are paired solutions, by the way. When y is equal to minus 3, x is equal to 5. When y is equal to 5/3, x is equal to 1/3. Now, you'll be pleased to know that just generating these x values by subbing back into here gives me a mark, and getting the correct values gives me an accuracy mark. Many people forget when they've got the Y to go back and get X. They're missing out on 2 marks there. So be very careful. 7-mark question. Work through it methodically. A question that says solve means find all of your variables. So your final answer will be what X equals and what Y equals. As a final point, quadratic equations often end up with 2 answers, so 2 Y values and 2 X values. Not always, but it's something to be aware of.